So good afternoon, everyone. My colleague and I, Prada, today are presenting our project, Mitigating Medical Fraud. And I would like to begin with a bit of a use case here. Now imagine an elderly lady visiting a doctor for an insurance checkup. And the doctor says, we need to monitor your heart to confirm it's working and confirm everything's fine. And he gives her something like this, a little medical device which you stick on your chest for a week. And the lady, fearful that she has something, sticks this on her grandson and says, hey, the data that's coming out of this is perfectly healthy. The doctor sees that healthy data is being put out. And she asks for insurance premium to be lowered. I mean, she says she's healthy again. There's nothing wrong with her. And this is a problem. This is medical identity theft. And data theft as well. It's a big problem in the insurance industry. Forbes has listed it as 45% of all hacks in the US. 92 million records are affected from companies like Anthem. And this is exactly what we're trying to solve. And how we plan to do it is to actually use your own heart data to identify yourself. This can actually solve the problem of data fraud and medical identity theft. And so if this is even possible, you're asking, MIT have done a very nice study on this, the feasibility of all of this study. So please check it out. And right now we'll head to our demo. So we actually have a little demo using 10 different sets of patient data. And we're able to correctly identify. So we begin by registering patient number one, the elderly lady visiting the clinic. And it registers the user. And a green circle would indicate that the user's been registered. And the patient is identified as the elderly lady. Now, let's say the elderly lady puts the device on someone else. Let's pick patient number five. And so the system checks it again. It verifies for the unique identifiers that we identify in each person. And a white circle appears. It's not the person, as mentioned, it's not the elderly lady. And this is a key method. We use this unique identifier for ID, for key generation, for encryption. And what are the benefits of this? We develop arrhythmia software. And this is actually a byproduct of it. So we don't need to collect any more data to identify people. There's no passwords. There's no nothing. It is persistent. It is on all the time as long as you're wearing a device for medical monitoring. It is passive. There's no active intervention needed. And the data encrypts itself. It's a form of security in itself. So who's using this? Medical device companies who could use this as value added to hospitals, patients protecting data from their own wearables, insurance companies correlating this with historical data. And the business model will basically be B2B, same as our own software, pay per ID, pay per kilobyte. And with this, doctors can now tell, I know for sure that this is your data and you're healthy and no fraud's been committed, and we are just a little bit step closer to mitigating medical fraud. Thank you.
Could you tell us when has this been scientifically verified?
Sure. So going back to the MIT study, historically, a company has already done this. MIT has proven it's between 96 to 100% depending on which model you use. We have tested it on 100 patients, and we have managed to get 100% success rate on 100 patients. The accuracy, of course, needs to improve dramatically to about 0.02%.
Have you tested on twins?
No, we don't have that kind of data yet. MIT have a nice list of data, but they don't tell us whether it's from twins. My wife's a twin, so maybe I could test it out on her.
Thanks very much.
Thank you.